Welcome to the city's Traffic Management Center, which is where you can see we've got our cameras showing what the traffic is doing and what the weather is doing. My name is Jennifer Gallagher. I'm the director of the Department of Public Service. And today we just want to talk a little bit about this particular storm, but also in general about the great team behind the scenes here at the City of Columbus who takes control of the snow and ice events. And many of you know them as our snow warriors. It also, however, they are more than just the men and women out in the plows. It's the men and women sitting in here, the ones over in the barns filling the trucks, making sure we have the materials needed, et cetera, et cetera. They have been preparing this week for this event, so we believe we are ready to go today. As you can tell, the temperatures are already dropping out there, and we will talk a little bit more after the mayor and council president Hardin speak in particular about this event. But we just wanted to make the citizens of Columbus know that we are prepared, we are ready for this event, and our entire team is ready to go. So I will turn it over to Mayor Ginther. We really appreciate his support throughout the year, but especially on these events when we have so many people working around the clock.
Thanks, Mayor. Director. And I know many of you joined us, I think it was a year or two ago that we were out here and unveiled this center and this system and talked a little bit about the changes that had been made after, I think, a storm of, was it 2014, 2013 that we had gone through and taking a look at our entire operation and how we can improve and enhance it. Part of it was investing in our people and training and equipment and resources, this center, so that we could make sure that our folks, who were a little biased, we think they're some of the best in the business, assistant director, and pretty good at dealing with these issues. And so we wanted to talk to folks and particularly thank these incredible public servants for the great work they do every day. Sometimes it may be just a few times a year that we're here in their offices and highlighting the great work that they do, but they're important because it's important to us to make sure that folks are able to get to and from home safely, work, school, and all the important places throughout our community to make sure that they have safe passage. So it's now my pleasure. I want to thank newest council member Emmanuel Remy for joining us here today. But I want to thank Council President Hardin because he currently serves, at least for maybe another week or two, as the chair of the Public Service and Transportation Committee. And during his time on council, he's been a great partner and advocate to make sure that this department and the director had the resources she need so that she and her team could serve us in these times of need. Council President Hardin.
Thank you, Mayor Ginther, and thank you, Director Gallagher. The mayor is right. For the past 3 years, I have had the opportunity to serve as chairperson of the Department of Public Service and Transportation. And as the mayor indicated, and as Director Gallagher, we have the best snow street operators anywhere in the country. I've had the opportunity to be here at this center, but also out at our outpost, and the men and women who work while we are asleep to clear the roads in an act of public safety are the best out there. I'm actually joined here with my colleague, Councilmember Emmanuel Remy, and a little bit of news. He will be the new chairman of Public Service and Transportation. And one thing, Councilmember, that our guys appreciate our donuts. And I saw the mayor walk in with a box of donuts for our guys. They certainly are deserving. But the work that is being done, you'll be able to see real hand. We rolled out several years ago Warrior Watch, and that's www.warriorwatch.gov. which allows all of our residents to go on their handheld devices or on your computer and see which streets have been plowed in real time. Again, this is a safety tool that we can all use as we see this inclement weather come in, and it will allow us to and allow you to see in real time the work that we're being that is being done. We are extremely proud of the folks that are out there doing the work. This storm, like the mayor said, is every storm is different, and so we will be watching and looking to these great folks and under Director Gallagher's leadership and Frank Williams here over the next several hours as this storm comes through. So thank you, Director.
Thank you. So as the mayor and Councilmember Harden have said, this storm is a little different, just as they all are. So this one is coming in, obviously, as rain first. What that means for us, unfortunately, is we cannot anti-ice like we would like to do. So we can't put down the brine or anything because the rain will immediately wash it away when it's raining as hard as it is. So what we are doing to prepare instead of putting the brine out is we are stationing our vehicles around the major corridors, the major roadways in the area. So once the temperatures start dropping and start hitting that freezing point, they are already on site, ready to go. So that you may see some plows sitting along 315, 104, 33, those type of roadways. That's not a bad thing. So they are there, so when the temperatures drop and it starts to become ice, they are already in position and not having to sit in rush hour traffic, which is unfortunately about the time that we believe this storm is going to hit and start really making that turn to ice. And then we're expecting it to turn to snow. The good thing about turning into snow then, of course, is you can start getting a little bit of traction. So we will be out. We have our crews already, like I said, they're already out. They're starting to station themselves. They will be out throughout the night. And then hopefully by morning time, when most of us are getting up and having our breakfast, we will start to get into cleanup mode. We think the storm will be done. The snow should be through at that point, and we will be able to start getting more into the priority twos, et cetera, at that time. Thank you for coming. Appreciate it.
Thank you. And I've got a second.